Hey, Headsqueezers, hope you're well. Andrew Chamberlain has got in touch on our Facebook page to ask, why does our voice sound different when it's recorded? This is a great one, this. I thought that I had a very kind of Barry White style
Dr. Merv
kind of voice until I watched some of these videos, and clearly I don't, do I? Please give us a thumbs up if you have also cringed at the sound of your own voice on a recording. Now, I've touched on the basics of sound before, so I'm not going to go into the super simple stuff, but when you hear that recording of your voice, say it's played out of a speaker over there, that sound travels as a series of vibrations through the air, goes into your ear and vibrates your eardrum. Now, if I just take my ear off, put that there, your vibrating eardrum then sets three little bones vibrating, the malleus, the incus and the stapes, the hammer, the anvil and the stirrup. They then send the vibrations into a spiral structure full of fluid with little hairs around the edge called a cochlea. That transfers those vibrations into nerve signals that are then sent up to the brain, and your brain perceives that as those sounds. So why, when you hear a recording of your voice, does it sound completely different to what you think your voice sounds of? Well, that's exactly it. It's because you can hear your voice in two different ways. The first way is by sending the air vibrating, and that travels propagates into your eardrum. But the second way is that your vocal cords vibrating actually sets up vibrations in your skull. And those vibrations travel through your skull and set your eardrum vibrating. But as those vibrations travel through the bone, they spread out. The notes actually lower, the frequencies drop. That means that when you hear that way, you hear a lower voice. So when you hear the recording, you think, that sounds a lot higher than what I hear in my head. Unfortunately, the reality is that what you hear on a recording is actually what you sound like. So you might not sound like a
chipmunk, but you definitely sound higher pitched than you think. It's just something I suppose we've just got to deal with, isn't it?
I think that one answers that one. If you've got any more questions on anything sound related or head related, please do get in touch. As normal, Twitter, Facebook or in the comments below. And also, if you enjoyed this video, maybe you're new to my strand or the Headsqueeze channel, give us a sub and you can get a whole load more of this juicy stuff in your feed. Until next time, happy head squeezing.